Welcome, 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 everybody, once again to another episode of Big Easy Collectibles. I want to thank each and every one of y'all for tuning in today and making us the number one show right here on the GXW Wrestling Network. I want to throw out a couple props out here this week. I want to thank my boy Chucky Z for his purchase. He purchased a nice championship belt for me. He's about to be the WWE World Heavyweight Champion. Chucky, your belt is on the way, brother. You can be the champion sooner than later, baby. I also want to throw a big shout out to my man Ron Cromartie with RC Creative. RC Creative, GXW Classics, kind of like the same type of a deal right here, but Ron does an awful lot for an awful lot of people behind the scenes. Nobody ever gets to see his face, but he deserves a whole lot of love for everything that he does for everybody. It ain't just a Big Easy. He works hard for everybody, and we need to show him some love and give him some props for it. Well, I know y'all are tired of hearing me talking, because it's all I do. It's what I do more than anything else in the world. So let's go ahead and get to what y'all really want to see. All of these fine collectibles right here. We're going to start off today with the WWE Funko Pops featuring The Undertaker and Paul Bearer. This was an exclusive to GameStop right here. They were the only company that carried these. Now, this particular one is an exclusive to the Big Easy Network, to Big Easy Collectibles right here. We're asking $40 on the Funko Pops with The Undertaker and Paul Bearer. Our next item up for sale is going to be Then, Now, and Forever Together WWE Elite Wrestling Figures. This set features the immortal Hulk Hogan from the night that he beat the Iron Sheik for the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Championship. It features a young Rocky Maivia from his debut. It's featuring Stone Cold Steve Austin. I know we got Steve Austin fans out there. Let me get a hell yeah from each and every one of you Stone Cold fans out there. That's what I'm talking about right there, baby. Hell yeah. And it's featuring the man herself, Becky Lynch, former women's champion, now kind of semi-retired, being a mom, raising a child. God bless you, Becky. Thank you for everything that you contributed to this great sport. We are asking on this set, we are asking $50 on the Mattel Then, Now, Forever Together set. Now, I know we got fans of a lot of the SmackDown product out here, and I know we got Bloodline fans. Right here for sale is an autographed 8x10 of Solo Sikoa. Solo Sikoa, we are asking $50 on Solo Sikoa today. I tell you what, he has really set SmackDown on fire, him and the new Bloodline, and he calls himself, come on everybody, what is it that he calls himself out there? The Tribal Chief. Yeah, but I got to tell you, I have to go along with Paul Heyman on this. You are not my Tribal Chief. Roman Reigns is on the way back. Solo, your days are numbered, baby. But right here, y'all can have him today for $50 for Solo Sikoa. Next, back in 1998, I was traveling for Father's Day through Charlotte, North Carolina. And my hero was the Nature Boy Ric Flair. Ric Flair owned four gold gems, just like the Four Horsemen, Daddy. There was four of them in Charlotte, North Carolina. So for Father's Day, my wife took me to visit each and every one of them. When we got to Charlotte, we stopped. We didn't have cell phones back in 1998. What did we use? We used pay phones to call people with. So this right here is the telephone, the Yellow Pages advertisement for Ric Flair's Gold's Gems, baby. This is for each and every gem that he had. It had all the numbers on there. We caught three of the four gems. They were incredible to see the stuff that Ric Flair had lined up in there. He had magazine covers. He had the actual NWA World Heavyweight Championship belt that he wore while he was champion there. We're asking $50 for that today. $50 for a small piece of Ric Flair history right there, because he does not own them gems any longer. And talking about Ric Flair. Woo, Ric Flair's pride and joy, baby, is his daughter Charlotte, the multi-time WWE Women's Champion. She's held the NXT Women's title. She's been the SmackDown champion, the Raw champion. And Charlotte, hey, anytime, any place that she decides to take one of them titles, it's going to be hers. Eventually, she's going to eclipse her daddy's record of 16 world championships. It's just a matter of time before she does it. This right here is certified by Big Easy Collectibles, as well as Beckett. Beckett has also certified this. We're asking $75 for the queen herself. Hey, you can hang her up on your wall, and she can go woo all night long to you, just like your daddy would. All right, the next item that we have for sale is going to be a Jack's Pacific set right here, featuring Evolution. Does anybody remember Evolution out there? Of course you do. They were one of the best factions of all time. This particular set right here is a three-pack set, and it features the World Heavyweight Champion at the time himself, Triple H, Hunter Hearst Helmsley, along with a very young upstart, Randy Orton, and the legend himself, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. This is a very, very rare piece. There was only 3,500 of these that were done, and these were done exclusively for Ringside Collectibles. But it can be yours today, right here, from the Big Easy Collectibles for $75. $75 for one of the greatest wrestling sets that's ever been put out. All right, now we're going to move on to one of the biggest, one of the best collectibles that you're ever going to find. This right here is a custom-made replica of the NWA World Heavyweight Championship. This belt first debuted in July the 20th, 1973 in Houston, Texas, and was awarded to Harley Race. Harley Race defended this belt that night against Jack Briscoe and lost the title to Jack Briscoe that night right there in Houston. The original belt was featured on red velvet, a large, large red velvet that didn't hold up very well. The belt was originally manufactured in Mexico. Jack Briscoe sent the plates along with what was left of the red velvet to Reggie Parks. Reggie Parks created a brand new strap for it and sent it back to Jack Briscoe. This belt carried on in existence until February of 1986 when it was replaced by Ric Flair with the big gold belt. Jim Crockett was taking over the NWA at the time. He wanted something to show that the NWA belonged to him now and that the world championship was his. So he had the big gold belt customized for Ric Flair. He even had Ric Flair's name on there. They had a removable plate on that. But this right here, at one time, when it was first built, it had a nameplate right there. But that didn't last very long before it was done away with. I think when Reggie Parkins redid the strap, that he took that little nameplate right off of there. I think the only nameplate that was ever on it was Jack Briscoe's. This is a piece of wrestling history right here. These plates on this belt are 4mm Zeke. This is an awesome piece for anybody's collection. I've been very proud to own this. And I'm very proud for somebody to take it from my collection to theirs. So folks, this belt right here, we are asking $250 for. For $250, you can be the NWA World Heavyweight Champion. Don't let it slip through your fingertips. Go ahead and reach out and place that order today. Now we're coming to the main event, Daddy. This is the biggest piece that we're going to show today. It doesn't look like it's very big, but for the history of this, it is. This is one of my Mid-Atlantic ring-used canvas collection pieces right here. This right here is a piece of 5x7 canvas that all the stars of Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling in the 80s wrestled on at the Richmond Coliseum. It's complete with a Mid-Atlantic logo in there, and it has 10 signatures on here. This is autographed by the Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson. It's autographed by beautiful Bobby Eaton, who is no longer with us. It was autographed by Magnum T.A. It was signed by Ivan Koloff, signed by Ricky Steamboat and Dave Hebner. You know, they were famous for WrestleMania. Dave Hebner refereed that famous match between Ricky Steamboat and Macho Man Randy Savage. Former announcer Rich Landrum, one of the best commentators to ever come through the Mid-Atlantic area. The Masked Superstar. And finally, the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant himself, Daddy, has signed this piece right here. This is a must-have for any Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling collector. I grew up with Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling, and to have something like this in your collection, I just can't say enough about it. Everybody should own a piece of history. Put that back right there. And that is everything today right here at Big Easy Collectibles. Once again, I want to thank each and every one of y'all for tuning in and helping to make us the number one program right here on the GXW Classics Network. Make sure you click like and subscribe down at the bottom. And if you see anything you like, make sure you reach out to us and let us know, just like my man Chuck Z did. He's got the World Heavyweight Championship. Hey, Gunther's not going to be the world champion no more. Chuck Z's going to be the world champion, baby. Hey, and you folks can too. So reach out to us. If there's anything that you like, anything that you're looking for, reach out to us and let us know. Maybe we'll have it in our collection and we can feature it on an episode for you. Once again, please like and subscribe. Thank you for tuning in to GXW Classic Network and the Big Easy Collectibles.